Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Monday, June 5th. We are going to have another very nice weather day today with temperatures well into the 70s, plenty of sunshine around, and no rain in the forecast. Our chief meteorologist Dan Zarrow says that's going to be the pattern for much of the week this week. We are looking at the possibility of some spotty showers and possibly a thunderstorm, but not the drenching rains that we really need. Dan's full forecast is available on air online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. It's an exclusive on New Jersey 101.5 and nj1015.com this morning. A teacher at Irvington High School documenting with pictures, videos, and detailed descriptions a series of serious health and safety issues that have been dragging on for years, issues the teacher claims are being completely ignored. The teacher wants to remain anonymous because they're concerned about retaliation. Many students, the teacher says, are completely out of control, skipping classes, fighting in the hallways, allowing gang members inside, and the school building itself like a haunted house on Halloween. You can see all of the photos and videos that have been shared with us and hear in the teacher's own words what's happening inside that school at nj1015.com this morning. Even as crews struggle to get full containment on the Allen Road wildfire burning in Bass River State Forest, about 40 miles away, another fire sparked up in Medford. This one could have been incredibly destructive. Forest Fire Chief Greg McLaughlin says they got really lucky. Containment lines quickly set and they held, saving dozens of homes. About 210 acres burned. Both fires now 100% contained. Crews remain on the scene to make sure they stay that way. You want to get a look inside what it's like fighting one of these massive blazes? Check out the gallery of photos at nj1015.com this morning. Results have come back on what killed two dead whales found floating off the coast of New York and New Jersey last week. Two dead humpback whales spotted Wednesday. The NOAA revealed the necropsy results, which found the injuries were caused by boat strikes. The one seen in Raritan Bay, a 28-foot female, had skull fractures and suffered a severed fin. The other off Long Island, a 47-foot male humpback, was badly decomposed and had bruising on both sides of its head and other signs of blunt force trauma. The suspect charged in the murder of that Sayreville councilwoman, Eunice Jumfer, has still not been extradited back to New Jersey. 29-year-old Rashid Ali Bynum remains jailed in Virginia, where he was arrested last week. An extradition hearing scheduled for Friday was postponed, but we don't know why. Bynum and Jumfer knew each other from church, but beyond that, little is known about their relationship. Prosecutors have yet to release a motive. Alerts are going up after a black bear was shot and killed in Plainfield last week. It aggressively ran towards a police officer who was helping to track it. It had been wandering around the city for days. Officers were trying to guide it out when it charged. State wildlife officials were on the scene when the bear was euthanized. Bear sightings and bear encounters continue to rise in New Jersey. Sightings have been confirmed in all 21 New Jersey counties. Many of you have written in to ask questions about the state's controversial transgender policy in schools. That is the subject of my latest Asked and Answered column. Is it true that schools cannot tell parents if their child changes gender identity? I answer that question and many more. If you want to see what the policy actually says and what it does not say, check it out at nj1015.com. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we are always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Monday, June 5th. Have a great day.